All content is publicly sourced and used under the USA Fair Use and UK Fair Dealing Guidelines. The things I say are strictly my opinion. Good afternoon, everyone. It's the Busy Bee with the Royal Tea. It is the 26th of January. Happy Tuesday to you. Hope you've all had a great day. We're almost through the week. Hope you're all getting by pretty well. It's been a pretty long day over here. I don't know how your day's been, but I've been busy ever since I started this morning. But that is another story for another time. I saw something so great today, I wanted to share it with you all. I don't know if you're aware of this, but this year is going to be 10 years since the Duchess of Cambridge married Prince William in April of 2011. Yes, I was thinking, I still say 2020, but we're in 2021, so you know. Anyway, but yes, 2011 they got married, so the Queen wants to find a way this year to honor Kate and, thank her for doing such a good job in the family for the last 10 years, and to subtly give the middle finger to Meghan at the same time. And I thought it was so great, and I thought you would all think it was wonderful too, so that's why I wanted to share it with you. Let's take a look at it. Let's dive right in. Queen to honor Kate Middleton, diss Meghan Markle in surprise ceremony? We're not sure if it's a job requirement or just one of the psychological effects of holding a position of authority over tens of millions of people, but queens are generally tough to please. That might go double for Queen Elizabeth II, who's been the reigning monarch in her country since the days when Winston Churchill was prime minister, Dwight D. Eisenhower was president, and landing on the moon was the stuff of distant dreams. Folks, when the Queen says, "Okay, Boomer," she's not clapping back at her elders. She's putting her whippersnapper kids in their place. In other words, QE2 is old, 94 years old to be exact, but it doesn't look as though she's planning to enter retirement anytime soon. It also doesn't look as though she'll be having any changes of heart with regard to the people who have failed to meet her lofty standards. That's good news if you're Kate Middleton. Not such good news if you're Meghan Markle. Yes, even though they now live on different continents, it seems the feud between Kate and Meghan is still going strong. Is there any doubt that it would ever stop? Meghan's never going to quit despising Kate. Let's see the reasons why. Kate's way prettier than Meghan. Kate has way more grace than Meghan. Kate's way more elegant than Meghan. Kate has more style than Meghan. Kate is endlessly more gracious than Meghan. I mean, the list goes on and on, does it not? And the most important thing, I'm sorry, I get tongue-tied today. I told you it's been another long day. The most best part about it is that Kate will always outrank Meghan. No matter what happens, Kate will always hold a higher position, and Meghan will always have to curtsy to Kate. And in the months to come, the situation might come to a head, all under the watchful eye of Her Majesty. The situation might come to a head. Shut up, B. March will mark 1 year since the Megxit agreement that allowed Harry and Meghan to leave the UK while still retaining some of their royal titles and privileges. The anniversary is significant as the arrangement is scheduled for a 1 year review by a panel of royals, which includes both Kate and the Queen. Now, when I saw that, I was wondering if that was a mistake. I never heard that Kate was on the panel. I know that it's Prince William, Prince Charles, and Her Majesty, but I've never heard about Kate being on there. Who will decide if the terms are working for everyone involved? Needless to say, Harry and Meg have a lot riding on the outcome, and insiders say the couple will make their first trip back to the UK together in order to meet with members of the so-called firm who will decide their fate. The following month brings an equally important anniversary, as it will mark 10 years since Kate married Prince William and became the Duchess of Cambridge. Insiders say Meghan's difficulties in the role of Duchess have made the Queen all the more appreciative of the ease with which Kate stepped into the role. And it seems Elizabeth is planning to make her affection known with a ceremony that will serve as both a celebration of Kate and a subtle middle finger directed toward Meghan. It's highly likely she'll be planning a special secret something to honor Kate's 10 years in the royal family, something she can do to market, royal expert Duncan Larcom tells the UK edition of Us Weekly. Kate and the Queen have a fantastic relationship, he adds. According to Larcom, the thing that's going around has actually made Kate and the Queen closer. Not only has the Queen been impressed with Kate's commitment to helping manage the crisis, she's also benefited from Middleton's technical know-how. And I'm sure she greatly appreciates the fact that when Kate helps the charity, she stays longer than 10 minutes and then doesn't sell the pictures that were taken by her own private photographer to every press outlet in the world, like her sister-in-law. Larcom says Kate has helped her grandmother-in-law master new to her technologies like FaceTime that allow her to keep in touch with her grandchildren. Insiders say Meghan has long felt that the Queen's favoritism toward Kate prevented her from ever giving her second granddaughter-in-law the chance she deserves. And if the hooray for... Let me stop right there. Meghan whining about the Queen not giving her a chance and showing favoritism to Kate, that is all a bunch of malarkey. The Queen paid for Meghan's wedding, and I've heard different accounts of how much it is. It's, you know, millions of dollars, you know, $16 million, $30 million, $40 million, whatever. Anyway, the Queen paid for it. The Queen literally did everything she could to show Meghan, you know, a good welcome to the family. And Meghan threw everything back in her face, unappreciative all the way around. So this stuff about the Queen showing favoritism to Kate, Kate hasn't taken everything that's been done for her and thrown it back in their face. So just take it and shut up, Meghan. And if the Hooray for Kate party follows closely on the heels of a Megxit review that goes poorly for the Sussexes, the party might be taken as the equivalent of going nuclear in posh royal way. Everybody, there's my social media info if you want to get in touch. Tips are greatly appreciated. There's my PayPal info. Thank you in advance. I thank you very much for watching. I truly appreciate each and every one of you. Please like, subscribe, comment, share, and hit that notification button. And I will see you all in the next one. Have a great evening, everybody. Bye-bye.